consumer equilibrium in terms of indifference curve analysis. The two tools that we are going to use in this connection are indifference map and budget line. Indifference map exhibits consumers' scale of preference for various combinations of two goods, say good X and good Y. Consumer is indifferent among combinations within the indifference curve and not between combinations on two different indifference curves. As the consumer is assumed to behave rationally, he wants to reach the highest possible indifference curve. His aim is to maximize his utility. But he is constrained by his income and the prices of goods X and Y. He can move inside the triangle AOB. He cannot move beyond the price line. A sensible consumer will move along the price line. That alone will exhaust his income after buying a combination. Well, we shall now define consumer equilibrium. Consumer is in equilibrium when he maximizes his utility. At that point, consumer will not have a tendency to rearrange his purchases of two goods. He will not have a tendency to reallocate his budget. To analyze the equilibrium of the consumer, we have to integrate indifference map with the price line. We know the consumer is going to choose any one of the combinations on the price line. As a first step, he fixes all the points common to both indifference curves and price line. They are D, F, C, G, and H. Consumer decides to move from point A. He moves down and reaches point D. He examines his position. He finds he is on indifference curve 1. He believes he can go for a higher level of utility. Again, he compares marginal rate of substitution of X for Y with the price ratio. The MRS of X for Y is greater than the price ratio. He substitutes good X for good Y and moves down. Listen carefully, substitutes X for Y. He reaches the point F. He is on indifference curve 2 now. Again, he compares marginal rate of substitution of X for Y with price ratio. MRS of X for Y is greater than price ratio. He feels there is still scope for maximizing his utility. He moves further down. he reaches point C. Once again he compares MRS of X for Y with price ratio. Both are equal. Point C is on indifference curve 3. This is the highest possible indifference curve that the consumer can reach. Hence, C is the point of equilibrium. Anyway, we have to examine points G and H. Now, we shall make the consumer to move from point B. He moves up to point H. Combination H is on indifference curve 1. Moreover, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y is less than the price ratio. Consumer, in order to reach a higher indifference curve, reallocates his budget and substitutes good Y for good X. Listen carefully. Now he substitutes Y for X. He moves to point G. This combination is on indifference curve 2. In this case also, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y is less than the price ratio. He rearranges his budget and substitutes Y for X. At last, he reaches point C. It is on the indifference curve 3. Here, MRS of X for Y is equal to the price ratio, even if the consumer wants to move to indifference curve 4. He cannot, because it lies to the right of the price line. It is beyond the reach of the consumer. So, indifference curve 3 is the maximum possible indifference curve consumer can reach with his budget and prices of the two goods are given. Once again, we shall recollect the equilibrium conditions. At the point of equilibrium, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y must be equal to the price ratio. Since MRS of X for Y is the slope of the indifference curve and the price ratio is equal to the slope of the price line, the slope of the indifference curve must be equal to the slope of the price line. Again, as the slope of the indifference curve is equal to the rate at which the consumer would like to exchange good X for good Y, and slope of the price line is equal to the market rate of exchange, the rate at which the consumer would like to exchange good X for good Y must be equal to the market rate of exchange. The equilibrium condition can be technically stated like this. At the point of equilibrium, first order condition, indifference curve must be tangential to the price line. Second order condition, marginal rate of substitution of X for Y must be diminishing, or indifference curve must be convex towards the origin. There ends our discussion. Thanks for watching. Meet you all again.